right, coming up next, a heavyweight collision between Anthony Johnson and Stipe Miocic. He is the UFC heavyweight champion, Croatian-American Stipe Miocic. He wanted to be a professional baseball player, but ultimately left that goal in pursuit of mixed martial arts glory. And y'all remember when he knocked out Fabricio Werdum in Brazil, no less, to realize that UFC heavyweight gold in 2016. They are still all chasing Stipe Miocic in this UFC heavyweight division.
This guy has incredible takedowns. The speed in which he delivers them and the power in which he executes them are world class.
Now based in Boca Raton, Florida, here is the former welterweight, if you can believe that, UFC light heavyweight contender, Anthony Rumble Johnson. When the matchmaker sends you a text message to fight this guy, either hit delete or don't reply. Not a lot of people lining up to face the power threat that is Anthony Rumble Johnson.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He can do it all. If the fight takes place standing or on the ground, he's going to be comfortable in all areas of the game.
Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Johnson is 33. Miocic is 35. He weighed in at 240 pounds. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. All right, now to get us started, we go inside the octagon where we find Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 2 losses. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of Independence, Ohio, Stipe Miocic! And now his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 22 wins, 6 losses. He stands 6 feet 2 inches tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Anthony Rumble Johnson! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Steve Ludwig.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
You ready?
All right, so this UFC Grand Prix tournament is coming up next. This format has been all the rage. A lot of the hardcore mixed martial arts fans out there, sort of an homage to the history of UFC and Pride with a single night tournament game event here. And let's see who can be the last man standing here tonight. Pretty good straight punch for him there, Joe. And just,
whoa! This could be it! This fight.
Oh!
Beautiful body shot there, too. Hurt him with that overhand. Oh, you flipped.
Oh!
Beautiful strike here to end the fight early in the first.
Yes, sir, it goes into the books as a first-round win by knockout, near-perfect execution. The technique was absolutely gorgeous, and again, when you catch a guy early, maybe you're getting him cold before he's had a chance to work up a sweat or even get into the fight a little bit. Those strikes can have a bigger effect, and it certainly did here tonight.
Great angle here. Crank right on the jaw.
So there he is after a monumental knockout turned in here tonight. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time.
Here's Bruce Buffer. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 1:08 of the very first round, declaring the winner by knockout! Anthony Rumble Johnson.
Well, congratulations are in order to Anthony Rumble Johnson. He came into the fight having won 8 UFC bonuses, and given that performance, I wouldn't be surprised to see him secure a 9th. I have called this guy the most vaunted power threat in the history of the UFC, and I think he showed you exactly why here tonight. Another major milestone checked off the bucket list for Anthony Rumble Johnson here tonight. All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight matchup between John Jones and Alexander Gustafsson. Well, he made his UFC debut back in 2009 and really has been competing with the elite ever since. Here is Sweden's finest, Alexander the Mauler Gustafsson. Twice he has fought for the UFC light heavyweight championship. Was very close to bringing that belt back to Sweden several years ago against John Jones. On any given Saturday night, you could be looking at the best 205-pound fighter in the world.
Alexander Gustafsson is one of the tallest fighters in the UFC's light heavyweight division, and that length and reach poses real problems for his opponents. He also has outstanding footwork and accurate striking technique.
So back in 2011, he became the youngest champion in UFC history. Johnny Bones has gone on to become the consensus greatest mixed martial artist of all time. Every skill in the book, he has got it. He has dominated. And in terms of the strength of schedule, you can argue no UFC champion has had it tougher than John Bones Jones.
John Jones, although he started out as a wrestler, has grown to become one of the very best strikers and submission artists in the UFC. Incredibly successful against high-level competition and at a very young age. In fact, the youngest ever light heavyweight champion in the history of the sport.
And now our tail of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Gustafsson is 1 year his senior. He is 1 inch taller. Jones will have a 5-inch reach advantage. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 4 losses. He stands 6'5" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Stockholm, Sweden, Alexander the Mauler Gustafsson! And now, here's his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A look-see-do fighter, holding a professional record of 23 wins, 1 loss, and 1 no contest. He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, John Bones Jones! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb Dean.
All right, Herb Dean, third man in the octagon for this one.
Ready.
Well, how good is this? Reminds me of the good old days of Pride, the UFC Grand Prix single night tournament. This has been highly anticipated by fight fans around the world. And remember, if you sustain damage, that could affect you later on in this one night tournament. And that left hook landed on the button. Gustafsson gets tattooed by that straight punch.
They have started this fight off with a brawl.
Damaging punch there. Try to establish that jab. And he connects with the punch.
Oh, you heard him with that one. This could be it right here.
Whoa! The left hook hits home.
With that huge kick.
defensively, leaving a lot to be desired there. He moved right into that hook. His head was wide open and there for the taking. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here moving forward.
Clean Superman punch.
How about that shin? Nice punch there by Gustafson.
And there he swung with a haymaker.
Just over 2 minutes to go. Just misses there with the left. Oh! Trying to establish that jab once again. Oh, straight to the body by Gustafson. Lands flush with that right hand. Just missed on the front kick there. 60 seconds. Under a minute to go in the round. Five seconds to go here in round one. Seconds to go. 20 seconds to go in round one.
That's a hard hook.
Hook lands right to the target, Joe.
And here, a perfectly placed punch results in a knockdown. Let's see it one more time.
Listen, relax and breathe. You're gonna be okay. It's fine. You've been here before. You just got clipped. I need you to go out there and I need...
The beautiful Jenny Andrade to get us going. Second round here.
That last round was absolutely insane. If this round gets off to anything like the last round, one of these guys is going out. I can't imagine a scenario where if they continue where they left off in the last round, that one of these guys doesn't get knocked out. Alexander the Mauler Gustafson is one of the...
Good right hand on the top. He's hurt. He's hurt.
He's
hurt.
Strike there by Johnny Bone. Oh, nice check on the leg kick offering there.
He's moving to the left, avoiding his opponent's big left hand.
Oh, and he connects there.
That one hurt.
Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
He's trying to hang on. Big spinning back fist lands. Really swung for the fences with that hook, but misses.
So we're...
Oh! He's badly, badly hurt. Oh, nailed it!
Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the message from his corner and picked up the pace here in round two. Jones gets caught with that punch. He's got to figure out a way to get that guard higher, Joe. Hand speed, man.
Stay focused, stay focused.
Well, he's landed some excellent shots in this fight tonight, but more often than not, it has been one and done. Looked
nice
like
shot.
It did stun him a little bit.
Oh, he's hurt!
Whoa!
He hurt him with that hook. Oh! What a leg kick! Inside leg kick by Jones.
Seconds to go in round two.
Nice jab.
20 seconds to go round two. Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Jones. All right, that's the end of round number two. All right, you hear the horn. Big, big round for him there. Multiple knockdowns. Huge round from Gustafson.
A huge round, and his opponent should be commended for even making it out of that round because, boy, did he take some damage. And here another big shot lands and another knockdown. And here another clean shot lands and another knockdown.
Catch your breath. Breathe. Listen, you can do this now. He is ready to be out of there, okay? You completely rocked him.
Thank you very much, Carly Baker.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Third and final round.
Now, starting off this round, you've got to think that the barrage that he endured in that last round is still affecting him. He's going to want to start this round off and move and avoid taking any damage. Oh, nice inside leg kick. Big power.
Going for the spinning side kick to the body, but he missed. And he continues to work on the inside of that lead leg. See the total strikes. Oh, he just continues to land with a high volume of strikes here. Not unlike the previous round, Joe, and at least if his body language is any indication.
Oh, he nailed him! He's clearly hurt.
Oh, he might be out.
It looks like he's injured.
How about that shin? Three minutes now to go in the fight. Oh, he's really starting to apply pressure on his opponent here. Different approach here in the last couple rounds, and it's the exact sense of urgency that you want to see from a fighter. Take the judges out of it. Under 2 minutes to go in round three. Good check of the leg kick, Joe. Nice punch there by Alexander Gustafson. Oh, blocks that kick to the body, Joe.
Oh,
huge right hand! Gustafson gets hit with a kick here. That one landed flush. Let's see if he can make some adjustments. Oh!
He's in trouble right now.
Time winding down, final seconds of the fight. Well, Gustafson's lower jaw could not look much worse, Joe. Extremely swollen at this point in time. We'll keep an eye on it as this fight moves forward.
And here's the end of the fight.
Official decision now in. The Buff has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score this contest
30-25.
To the winner by unanimous decision, Alexander the Mauler Gustafsson!
Man, so with an entire nation on his back, Alexander Gustafsson gets the job done yet again. When he puts it all together, there may be no more exciting fighter on this UFC roster. You gotta think before his career is said and done, Gustafsson will eventually be belted with that elusive UFC gold.
Darling, I see that you're dangerous. You got a lot of dudes for a base in. I stay true to the statements. We should go.
All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between Anderson the Spider Silva and Francis Ngannou. All right, so here is Francis Ngannou. He has finished all of his UFC wins. This is one of the more frightening heavyweights on the roster at present. His head coach, Fernan Lopez, says he's one of the more coachable guys he has ever trained. Quick learner, explosive, strong, high fight IQ, plus athlete whose frame is only getting stronger, a scary proposition for the rest of this heavyweight division.
This guy is a boxer, and he will have a distinct advantage if this fight goes in boxing distance, whether it's up against the cage with dirty boxing or in the center of the octagon where he can utilize his superior accuracy.
So here he is, the Curitiba, Brazil native, Anderson the Spider Silva, still considered by many to be the greatest of all time. You know what he did at the beginning of his UFC career, 16-0, 10 successful middleweight title defenses, and is still proving deep into his 40s that he can still be competitive. This is a guy who still has the hunger and the drive to make the walk, and as such, with his sons in his corner at times, Anderson Silva still competing and getting it done.
Anderson Silva's the most accurate striker we have ever measured in the UFC. Incredible timing, devastating Muay Thai technique, and a really underappreciated ground game to go with it.
Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. So more than 10 years apart, these two fighters, with similar height and some differences in reach. All right, now for the introductions, we go to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a boxer holding a professional record of 11 wins, 2 losses. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 250 pounds. Fighting out of Paris, France, Francis the Predator Ngannou! And now, Francis, fighting out of the red corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 34 wins, 8 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Curitiba, Brazil, Anderson, the Spider Silva! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Mario Yamasaki.
Mario Yamasaki, third man in the octagon for this one.
You ready? Let's go, come on! Here we go.
Wow. Silva gets caught with that punch. And an outside leg kick lands. Oh, like the thought there. Good attempt at a counter. Ultimately, it's no good.
Clean inside leg kick. Misses a huge hook to the head.
And able to avoid the punch there. Nice slip by Silva, lands flush.
Good right hand. Oh! He is hurt. Oh, look at this. Who saw that coming?
Nice kick there by Silva. Oh!
Oh, he got clipped there. He got hurt. He's getting tagged. What a leg kick. Big straight punch. Oh, very nice.
How about that shin? Slips the punch. Oh!
Oh, another shot. He's hurt bad. He's in big, big trouble here. Oh!
Oh, he might be out.
Big power in that hook.
Joe. To the jab now, no good. Under 2 minutes to go in the round. Checks the leg kick. Well, he's doing a nice job keeping the guard up, but that usually means the body is wide open, and his opponent wisely saw that and landed the straight hand to the body.
Oh, another one!
He's gotten hurt here.
Beautiful accuracy on the right hand for the victory.
Yeah, Joe, just the way he drew it up as he gets the knockout victory here tonight, it's hard to land a strike more flush than he did right there, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So he'll see the replay and probably shake his head, but ultimately this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight.
Check it out here. Bang.
So a strong candidate for some bonus money there. A huge knockout for him here tonight. Near perfect execution. They'll be talking about this result for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki is called to stop this contest at 3:59 of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Francis the Predator Ngannou.
So the Predator, Francis Ngannou, gets the job done yet again, and no surprise, with authority here tonight. Absolutely remarkable what this Cameroonian Frenchman has accomplished thus far, and the best could still be yet to come. It is a heavyweight collision between Junior Dos Santos and the Reem, Alistair Overeem. Well, he has challenged for UFC gold outside the octagon. He's accomplished really as much as any heavyweight in the sport. The Reem, Alistair Overeem, is back tonight. And this is a guy who has really maintained his focus nearly 60 fights into a career that dates to 1999. That doesn't even mention his K-1 accolades. Alistair Overeem, a threat as always. Good to see him turn around quickly to compete again tonight.
Alistair Overeem, the former Strikeforce heavyweight champion, the former Dream heavyweight champion, and the former K-1 heavyweight Grand Prix champion, is one of the most decorated fighters in the history of mixed martial arts.
So here is the two-time UFC heavyweight champion, Junior Dos Santos, mentored by the great UFC Hall of Famer, Minotauro Nogueira. Ngannou has really become one of the best boxers, Joe, this division has ever seen. Certainly has that takedown defense if he wants to keep the fight upright in his wheelhouse. can fall back on the jiu-jitsu black belt if needed, but Junior Dos Santos figures to be looking to throw hands here early and often tonight.
Junior Dos Santos is a very dangerous striker. He's got precision punches with knockout power behind them. He has been putting top-level guys to sleep since he came to the UFC.
And now our tail of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Dos Santos is 34, Overeem is 37. He weighed in at 265 pounds. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. All right, now to get us started with the introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 43 wins, 16 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Amsterdam, the Netherlands, Alistair the Reed Overeem! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 5 losses. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 238 pounds. Fighting out of Salvador Bahia, Brazil, Junior Chicano Dos Santos! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Mario Yamasaki.
Mario Yamasaki, our third man in the octagon.
First round, you ready? You ready?
Well, no better way to pay homage to the history of pride in the UFC with this single night. Wow!
This fight is dangerously close to being stopped. Hard straight punch.
Finds a home for that left hook.
Here's a nice inside leg kick.
Well, he's playing with fire here, Joe. He continues to be vulnerable to that jab by almost leaning into it right into his opponent's range. Gotta find a way to move those feet and ultimately get that head off of the center line.
He's trying to stay up. Big shots. Hard kick lands. He's in a lot of trouble.
Oh, nice strike landed there by Dos Santos. The left hook hits home. Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very fast-paced opening round here.
Try some serious power in that kick, but misses.
Tags him with the uppercut.
He's looking for that elbow.
Dos Santos gets caught by that straight punch there. Oh, trying to turn out the lights with that roundhouse kick, but just misses.
He caught the kick.
Catches the leg, then decides to let it go. Dos Santos gets caught by the inside leg kick.
He faints with the kick. It appears that cut is getting worse. Tries a big hook to the head, but misses.
He missed with that jab attempt there.
Nice straight right.
45 seconds to go here in round one.
Attempts a big hook to the head, but misses. Oh, man, with that right leg kick. Oh, big, big body kick. Woo! Woo! Look at that jab. Oh!
So there's the horn at the end of the round. He got knocked down near the end of it, saved by the bell. He will live to fight on. The question is for how long?
Let's take a look at some of the action from this round. Here's a perfectly placed kick that results in a knockdown. Let's take a look at it from a different angle.
Ariani Celeste doing work as usual. Round two here. Oh, nice slip there to avoid the punch by Overeem. Oh, right hand is there for him, Joe. Oh!
What a shot! What a shot by Junior!
He's got him hurt here.
Junior's looking to really put some speed behind that right hand.
Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. And he connects there, Joe. Hand speed, man. Well, the offense has been there. He is landing some good shots, but not really stringing them together and putting combinations on his opponent. He's got to mix up his strikes, change his tempo a little bit, and try to get his opponent out of there by landing more than just one strike at a time.
How about that shin?
Joey missed with that straight right attempt. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. That one appeared to stun him.
That one hurt him badly.
Oh, he might be out. Straight right hand, no good.
Oh, nice.
And now he lands a combination.
Body kick, look at that. He's fainting with that kick.
Well, straight right hand has been a good weapon for him. He misses with it there.
Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed.
Oh! Oh, he's out. And just like that, the fight is over. Oh.
Beautiful, accurate uppercut that got him the win.
Yeah, man, crowd loving it. Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight.
And here's the end. Here we see it from another camera angle. And here we see it again.
Boom. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the huge knockout victory. That could hold up as one of the better knockouts of the year. All right, Bruce Buffer now inside the octagon has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki is called to stop this contest at 3 minutes, 39 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout, Junior Chicago Dos Santos.
All right, so congratulations are in order to Sagano. Junior Dos Santos on yet another big UFC win here tonight. And maybe his son Bento, even old enough now to be watching his dad go to work. If so, what an inspiring effort he saw in this one. The former UFC heavyweight king, Junior Dos Santos, lighting up this arena.